those of you who just turned in, we're talking with Lenny Otis. He's the leader of the Eddie Cochran fan club. So, Lenny, do you remember when he died?
What, you mean the actual date or exactly when it happened?
When it happened, the exact day.
I was one.
See, I was three, but I remember it like it was yesterday. Out of the blue, I felt depressed for no reason whatsoever. Just this dark cloud hanging over my head. I was gonna commit suicide. I was actually gonna commit suicide. I was gonna go up in the bathroom, I was gonna fill a tub of hot water, and I was gonna slice open my veins. I was gonna do it. Now, for a three-year-old to be thinking like that, that's really depressing. You know what saved me? It was the Partridge Family. So the Partridge Family was coming on, I really wanted to see it, so I thought, okay, I'll watch the Partridge Family, then I'll kill myself. And, I watched it, and it was a really funny episode. It was one of the ones where Danny got in trouble with the mom. Well, it was a really funny one. And I didn't feel like killing myself afterwards. It all kind of worked out. What were we talking about?
Yo, K-Billy. Request? Okay, what is it? Wadliacha. What's Wadliacha?
Hey, no babe.
All right. Wadliacha, Wadliacha, diddly-doo, diddly-doo. Okay, yeah, sure, I remember that. We don't have that record. No? No, why don't you try K-Scout? No, we don't have Teddy Bear's Picnic either. No. So, can it be that you perished the thought or actually early?
No, I was in the area, so I thought I'd stop on by. Got anything to eat? Any, ho-hos or, flaky flicks?
You mean flaky flicks?
Yeah, you got some?
Just animal crackers. Hey, don't eat the gorillas.
Hey, listen, I'm gonna conk out in the lounge for a couple hours. Can you wake me when it's time to relieve Clarence?
You look like shit.
Funny, I feel like diarrhea. It feels like a bunch of little guys are in my stomach with pointy sticks going, ay, 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 ay.
What the hell happened to you last night?
I was out with Jerry. You know Jerry?
Harry's brother, Jerry.
The same. Anyways, we were experimenting with this shit. It was so strong, I think a Indian tribe in Brazil has formed this religion around it.
You okay, Billy? Oh, Grandma Mommy. Yeah, how you doing?
Some gum?
He's good. Uh-huh. Yeah, how's Grandpa? Uh-huh. Yeah, so, what is that, church?
What the fuck is this shit?
What's the matter? Don't you like garlic gum?
Oh, you're the biggest asshole.
Last night, Jerry and I, we got really stoned, okay? Got all fucked up. We went into this novelty shop. Have you ever been in a novelty shop fucked up? It's an experience, let me tell you. About $150 worth of shit, okay?
Fucking
I picked up some itching powder for Clarence, because I knew he's the guy who could appreciate it, you know?
You are the biggest fucking asshole I ever remember my goddamn life.
I got Clarence some itching powder. They had the white kind, and they had the brown kind. I got him the white kind because the guy told me it's the industrial strength.
Why the fuck would he be here, you fucking bastard?
Put a little dab on the back of your hand, it drives you crazy. You just gotta wash it right off.
Jesus, god damn these things, anyway. Jesus, look at these fucking things. Boy, that's a dickweed.
Meg, grandma.
Grandma Mommy, hi, sorry, I got called away there. you were talking about the Young People's Fellowship?
Was this a gorilla?
So anyway, skip 20 years later, I find out that the very day that I feel so depressed for no reason whatsoever just so happens to be the very same day that the greatest rock and roller of all time buys the farm. You could have spit my socks. I mean, I couldn't believe it. I mean, it's crazy. But you know, in a way, there's a certain symmetry that I guess. I mean, in a little way. What's the word I'm looking for? It means disciples in what you'd be doing. You know what I mean?
Members.
Members, that's it, members. How many members do you have?
About 600 in the California area.
That's a lot. That's an awful lot, actually. Do you guys, like, have a get-together every year to, like, a Motel 6 or a Sambo's or something?
Every once in a while, we work something out.
Oh, that sounds like okay. We're here with Lenny Otis, the leader of the Eddie Cochran fan club, and we're going to be back in one hot second, so don't go away. Going okay, come see, come saw. What do you got in that box there?
Oh, You know, on March 29th, 1959, Eddie Cochran actually wiped his mouth with this?
Boy, that sounds really good. You should be bringing stuff like that out. I mean, I'm sure you got a cornucopia of stuff in that box. Just start bringing it out because, you know, this is radio. This is not television. You got it. They got to hear it. Clarence Poole Show. No, I'm sorry. I don't play requests. Because when I'm Jock, I play what I want to play when I want to play it. Oh, someday maybe you can be a jock and you can play what you want to play. Oh, if your taste is respected as mine, you will. Well, I don't give a shit what Unruly Julie plays in her show. No, I don't care. Look, well, then listen to Unruly Julie then, dick bait. Well, fuck your mama. Fucking ass. Clutch, what the hell are you doing here?
Well, I'm just hanging out till you're done.
This is, introduce you. What the hell is your name, kid?
I'm Lenny Otis. I'm the head of the Southern California chapter of the Eddie Cochran Fan Club.
Oh, Otis, like the town drunk on the Andy Griffith Show.
Yes, I was thinking the same thing.
Is this a wet fish? Clarence, have I got something for you.
Holy shit.
I picked some up for myself last night, and I got you some, too, because I knew you could put some good use to it. Jerry and I, you know, Jerry, we got fucked up last night. We went into this novel.
Meg?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's right here. Hold on.
Yeah, Meg, what is it? A girl, what's her name? Polly. What, Polly? Polly is on the phone right now for me? Listen, don't hang up. Don't hang her up. Keep her on the line. I'll be out there in a minute, okay? Don't let her go under no circumstances. Don't let her go. I'll be right there. I'll be back.
So, Leno, you're cool, right?
Yeah, I'm cool.
Good. This is, I can't fucking believe this. So, Lenny, do you want some Tutankhamun here?
No, thanks.
Ah, too cool. Way to be. Wish someone to stop me. Jesus Christ! Do I get anything in my nose?
Not right here.
Okay. Cool. Okay. Ready?
Yeah.
It's K-Billy, and we're back on the air. We're here with the leader of the Eddie Cochran Fan Club, Lenny Otis. Now, Lenny, what got you into Eddie?
Well, actually, my father was really into Eddie Cochran. He had a lot of his albums. He used to play them a lot.
I don't believe you're bringing him up. You know I hate him. I always have. Her too, okay? Together, I hate him.
And at the time, he used to play it a lot, and there was a time in my life where I really needed to hear that song for some reason. It just really applied to my life, and it got me out of this rut.
Could I get that napkin over here?
Sure.
Thank you.
Well, anyway, when I would feel down and lonely, I would just flip on this song, and hell, everything would be great. One day, I just had this real bad feeling about myself.
I don't believe you're bringing this up. I've never gotten along with him. Look. As long as we're burying our souls here and making a list of people we hate, why don't you add your name to that list, huh? I mean, you fuck!
Brian, Eddie Eddie Cochran out.
I am in hell!
Oh! Oh, you all right?
911.
What happened? Look, all he did was snort some of that coke you gave him.
What the hell are you doing here?
Hi, Mickey.
You back?
Yeah.
You're back.
I'm here, aren't I?
I'm glad. How long's it been?
Since what?
Since the last time we've seen each other.
Well, let's see. January, February, 2 months.
Seems a hell of a lot longer to me. Oh, by the way, you know those phone calls you were getting last month? They'd ring and you'd answer and they'd hang up?
Uh-huh.
Well, that was me. I just had to hear the sound of your voice. So what's it been like for you?
Well, I've been...
I'm sorry, I don't mean to cut you short, baby. It's just that I'm so happy. Well, I've been going through hell without you. You know, you and I argue about the stupidest things, but never again. Now that I've got you, I'm going to never let you go. And that's a promise, baby.
Mickey, being so nice.
And that's the way I'm going to be from now on. Forever and ever and ever. Feel my heartbeat. Feel it. Fast, ain't it?
Uh-huh.
Well, let me feel yours. Uh-huh. Just as I thought, just like mine. A mile a minute. Must be love. Honey, I want you to know that last few times we talked on the phone, I didn't mean any of that. You know that, don't you?
I thought you hated me.
I was just bluffing. I just wanted you to think I hated you. All I felt was, what do I do now? I was angry at you. Listening to you was just so frustrating. But I never stopped loving you.
I'm a little surprised. I've never seen you so sweet before.
This is going to be a happy birthday after all. Whoa. Is that why you stopped by? You remembered my birthday. Now tell me in your own words. And I promise I won't interrupt.
Well, yesterday I was talking to Yolanda Waxman. Do you remember her?
Yeah.
Okay. I was telling her about this really sad Rod Stewart song, and we're looking through my albums, and I can't find it. And then I remember it's not an album, it's a tape. And I left all my tapes over here. So I came by and picked it up, and I found it. See?
That's why you came by?
Oh, and guess what else? When I was going through my records, I found one of your Elvis Presley albums, and I knew you couldn't live without that, so I dropped it off. God, this place looks so empty without my stuff. Maybe I should have left you some of my plants.
What's that?
It's toilet flushing.
Man, talk about dropping a cheese bomb. Wouldn't run there by an hour, has he?
Oliver, darling, come over here. Oliver, I want you to meet one of my oldest friends, Mickey. Mickey, this is one of my newest friends, Oliver Brandon.
Hi, guy.
How the hell did you get in here? You gave me your key.
Well, Ollie got us in.
Yeah, I hope you don't mind, guy. You know, the old credit card in the lock routine. Had to get Sugar here, her Rod Stewart. I see you like Elvis, huh? Yeah, that's nice, that's nice. I got an aunt that likes Elvis.
Oliver's a really great actor.
You should talk. You're pretty great yourself.
I'm not.
You are.
I'm not.
You are.
You're better.
No, I'm not.
You are.
No, I'm not.
You are so. Don't believe a word he says. He's really glorious. Oh, I'm so stupid. I forgot to tell you the most exciting news. I got a part in a play. It's the Torrance Community Theater production of Godspell. That's where I met Oliver. Tell him what part you play.
Jesus. Well, look, we gotta go, you know. We gotta go to that thing tonight.
What thing?
You know, that big thing that we have to go to, and we're late now, so we better get a move on.
Okay, whatever. Bye, Mickey. Call me up sometimes, and we'll talk.
It's time, and we have to go.
Okay. Godspell opens on the 19th. I'll leave you a ticket at the door, you know, so you can get in free to see me.
Later, guy.
Did you used to have a scene with that guy?
A little one.
Yeah, that's what you like. You know Jake Stevenson?
Oh, yeah. He's my very favorite.
Oh, that's... I am impressed. That is really good. Yeah, I thought I was the only guy around here that had any kind of musical taste whatsoever. Except for me. He's got a really good taste. And now there's you. Boy. You know, you shake and see if that is. You know something? You shoot a game of pool. You like good music, and you got a really cool name. How'd you like to go out to a party?
Sure.
You would?
Sure.
Oh, this is kismet. This is just fantastic. Okay. I got a best friend. It's his birthday today. And if that's at all possible, I'd like to set you up. You see, he's just the best guy that there is in the world. And I'd only set him up with somebody who's, like, really cool like you. You think you might be interested in something like that? Oh, yeah, this is great. Oh, this is just, I'm reeling. This is just fantastic. Okay, tell you what. You got kind of something in a...
Oh, I have a lip liner. We can
do that. Oh, that's no problem. I can get my last penny with mine.
You want to use those?
Yeah, bring this down here.
What do you write?
His address. Now, just go there and entertain him. You know, show him a good time.
Okay.
All right? Then you'll play back in.
How
am I going to
get in?
Okay, let me
get you. You got a key.
Yeah, we're best friends. We have three kids in this class.
Okay.
Now, the thing is, when you get through, talk him into coming over.
Okay.
All right, he knows the directions. I got a little group thing set up for him. Me and you and him and my girlfriend. And we'll have a nice little party, okay?
Great.
Oh, this is great.
Should we talk price now or later?
Come again?
Price, you know. My price.
Oh, your price! Yeah. Price.
Yeah.
Kind of stupid today. Okay, sure, how much?
Well, how much do you think?
Well, how much do you usually charge?
Well, how much do you usually pay?
Usually the going rate is what I usually
pay. The going rate? Oh, well, see, I'm not a whore. I'm a call girl, and call girls, well, they're a lot more classier.
Oh, I knew that. I knew that when I came over here that you were a call girl. I mean, you're not a whore, and I would never, ever even think about getting a whore for Mickey, because he's the best, and you're, you know, your class.
Really?
Yes. That's,
really?
That's the honest to God truth. They no lie. Indian, honest engine.
Okay, then how about,
$40.
$30.
40! 40! 40!
Okay, I'll go 40.
You go 40?
42.
Okay, I'll pay for it.
Okay.
Okay.
The money?
Okay,
Phone, take this phone. Huh? Keep my hand on this fuck. I can't deal with that guy anymore.
Wait, do you have to say fuck in front of the customers?
Wait, does it sound better coming out of your mouth, huh? It's all right coming out of a man's mouth. Am I right about it? You've heard the word before, haven't you, buddy?
I haven't noticed. It's a new age. I can say anything you can say.
Hey, just bump my ass. Get me off. Get me off. You know, so...
I heard once the marriage starts, the romance is gone.
No, not so. Not so. Tell him, right, honey? Huh? It's still going strong. Am I right? I love her. She wasn't good in the sack. Fuck, I'd be out of here in 2 minutes, you know?
I want the coolest looking cake you got there.
Oh, my cakes are cool. Come on.
I want that one.
You want the one with the art?
With the squiggly and the little things on it.
Okay,
that's the one for Mickey. Nothing but the best for Mickey, and I want that one.
I got news for you. It's delicious, okay?
Three threes.
Three what?
Three threes.
Threes, huh?
Yeah, you're gonna write on that for me, aren't you?
Yeah, I'm gonna write on it, Clarence. Give me a chance, huh? Give me a chance to get it ready. Not the greatest box, but it's a box, right?
I just need it to take it home. I'm gonna give it to him, not in the box. I'm gonna give it to him with camera.
You know, I was thinking about something, you know. It's been something that's really been bothering me. I mean, it's not like I don't disagree with you. I mean, as a singer, Elvis, I mean, as a performer with albums and recordings, nobody could lay a hand on him. I agree. Okay? All right. So, right?
Right.
All right. So we got no problem, right?
We got no problem as far as him.
As an actor, Clarence, he was a lost cause.
This is where we differ. No. This is where we will always differ.
There's no argument. There's no argument.
We're always going to do that.
I'm sorry.
The same goddamn...
Marlon Brando is a great actor,
and
Clarence.
He made some shitty movies. Contessa from Hong Kong
never,
is a shitty
never
movie.
Never made a shitty movie, Clarence.
Contessa from Hong
never
Kong
never made a shitty movie.
Dick.
Marlon
movies,
Brando
man.
Is a great actor,
movies.
Clarence. You understand me? Huh? You ever see The Wild One?
Hi, Mickey. I'm Misty Knight, your birthday surprise. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Mickey. Happy birthday to you. Yay! Now, I will wait outside for you, and when you're done in here, you come out there and we will start our party. Okay? Okay. Oh, and keep it casual. What you have on is fine.
Stephen Hausrock, he's everything rockabilly's about. I mean, he is rockabilly. Mean, nasty, rude. I mean, he couldn't give a fuck about anything except rock and roll and live fast, die young, and have a good-looking corpse. Love listening to the party. After he's made it big, there was that big cocktail party. All those highbrows are there, singing, baby, you're so square, baby, I don't care. They got him dressed like a little dick. I mean, yeah, they got him wearing these stupid pants, a turtleneck sweater. I thought it was like no sweater. And they even got him wearing, I think, penny loafers, for Christ's sake. It doesn't matter. All the highbrows at the party, the big house, stupid clothes. He's still a rude-looking motherfucker. See, I look at him. I'd want to be him so bad. I mean, Elvis looked good. I'm no fag, but Elvis was good looking. I always said, you know, if ever I had to fuck a guy, I mean, had to because, like, my life depended on it, I'd fuck Elvis.
Yeah, yeah, well, I know what you mean. I wouldn't go so far as saying that I'd fuck him, you know. Of him on my wall. I used to say, hey, Big E. I used to call it, am I right, honey? I call him Big E.
Big E.
Huh? Big E. I say, hey, Big E, I love you. Come on, you can do it.
I hear you talking. I'm getting
still in all, still in all. I got to give the Beatles their due. They came out with Sergeant Lonely, what was it?
Sergeant Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band.
Sergeant Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band. And what does Elvis do?
A wonderful
album. What does the King do? He comes out with the soundtrack from It Happened at the Fair.
It Happened at the World's Fair.
Please, all right.
You might as well come out with Roustabout.
Please. What do you want on this cake, Clarence, huh? Huh? It's very disturbing, you know? I mean, when you think you got the answer and you can't get through, how can you get through? Colonel Park, he's got the guy surrounded
he's
like a
asshole.
Fortress.
Colonel
Am I right?
Is an asshole.
Am I right?
Yeah.
If you just let the fans tell Elvis what to do.
Right.
Elvis, like you and me.
After he got out of the army,
what do you want
it just wasn't
on the
quite the same.
Cake? Huh?
Okay. Friendship. You ready there?
What's going on?
Okay.
What's going on?
He wants to leave early. He came in late. He wants to leave early.
I don't believe. Where are you going? Huh? You going to college? You're here because you're not in college.
Exactly.
You've got things to do. Don't ever get married. Don't ever get divorced.
And don't ever have a son.
Especially a baboon. He belongs in a leper colony with a phone attached to his cock.
Friendship. Friendship will always be love between
Jerry
and me.
Don't argue with Roxy. You do what she tells you. Go on, I'm listening.
Okay. Friendship will always be the love between Mickey and me. The joy of always knowing our love is growing because our friendship is showing through the nose of the...
Hold it. Time out, Green Bay. I can't fit that all on fucking cake. Come on, look at...
Why not?
Look at the size of the cake. Do you see the same cake, all right? It won't all go on there.
Okay, what I said, how much of what I said can you get on the cake?
I can get maybe Happy Birthday Mickey.
Would you put me down? Come on, quit being so weird. I'll put you down.
Get off
let,
my bed.
I swear, let go of me.
No, you're right. I really could use this.
You! Your ass is grass and I'm the lawnmower.
Oh, Susie, will you listen to yourself?
Dr. Reichardt, I can't live like this anymore. I got one on one end and one on the other. I mean, it's tearing me apart.
Whenever there's a way in, there's a way out. And this is the same goes for the situation.
Well, I could make a stand and get out of the middle.
This is the operator. We have an emergency call for Cecilia Webb from Alda Ray.
Alda Ray?
Cecilia, I never knew you knew Aldo Ray.
I don't know Aldo Ray. Doctor, let me call you back. Hello?
Hello, baby.
Clarence.
Oh, yeah, who are you expecting? Aldo Ray? Now, look, Cecilia, no. The reason I called you is because I'm having a party, and I want you to come down here. And it's in my place. Except it's for my best friend, Mickey. Yeah, it's his birthday. Yeah, but he doesn't know
you.
No. It's just going to be you, me, and him, and his girlfriend, who he hasn't met yet, but he don't know that yet. But he will. Don't worry about that.
Clarence.
No. Just wear any old thing as long as it's nice.
Look. Okay, in fact, I can't ever see you again.
Look, this has the familiar ring of that lunkhead boyfriend of yours. Is this it?
Yes, it's Eddie, and he's been spying on me, and he knows that we've been seeing each other.
So?
So you don't know Eddie. He is really strong. And really mean.
Kill something!
And really jealous.
Freeze, Fudge Packer!
And I'm very pissed, all right? You tell Deputy Dog this for me, all right? Okay, he's opened up a Pandora's box and he's gonna wish he had kept closed. Because he's getting me pissed. And when I get pissed, watch out.
Right now, let me take you by the hand. Right now. Put your lips at my command, right now. Fly me off to lover's land. Don't leave me at the phone. Coast to coast, right now.
Hello, baby. You just reached the ring of ding of the original Hillbilly Cat, Clarence Boone. And I'm gone. Oh, now, to all you hip cats and kittens, will you leave to thump up the sound of the guitar, Lynn? And as soon as I'm done with my frisk fist special, I'll try not to drag my axle in waltz time and get back to ya. Bye.
You asshole. This is Eddie. I hope you know who I am. I hope that name means something to you. I'm the man who's gonna dropkick you to hell. Cecilia's my woman. She's my property, and you've been messing with her. Look, garbage can. When I lay my hands on you, I'm gonna punch a hole through your rockabilly face. Then I'm gonna body slam your rockabilly carcass to the ground.
Got a whole bunch of them all over the place. It's called Rockabilly Burger.
Rockabilly,
you put these music, Elvis all over the place. Then the bread is this great. You have the breakfast burrito, Bebopalooza Burger, go rock, rock, rockabilly burger. One bite leaves you ready.
On my way.
Right now,
right now,
or a ride to outer space. Right now.
Clarence, I'm leaving Eddie. from now on, I make my own decisions. He didn't own me. Nobody owns me. I'm making my own.
Who are you?
Who are you?
You and, Clarence
are what?
You and Clarence don't go to gay bars together, do you?
No, we don't go to gay bars together.
Oh. Oh. Where's Clarence?
Obviously not in here.
So what's going on?
Look, you had your chance. I love you and everything, but you're going to have to wait until I get done here. I'll find somebody for you, I promise.
Yeah, bye-bye.
Goodbye.
Okay. The Guinness World Book of Records for a fellatio is not in here. It doesn't exist. However, for kissing, it's 3 hours and 20 minutes.
I can do that.
Okay, here we go. You ready? Now.
What can I get you?
You're falling in love again.
Where is she? The girl with the asshole. The girl without
assholes?
Listen up, butt breath. My girlfriend comes in here and meets a rockabilly asshole named Clarence Poole. I know because I bought the bitch here a week ago. Where is she?
She's at the asshole's apartment.
Where does the asshole live?
The asshole lives at Harry's apartment over on Eastwood Drive.
Some folks run, others hide. There ain't nothing they can do. And some folks put on armor, but the arrow goes straight through. So you see, no escape.
Why not
face it?
Apartment 44.
That you love.
How long have you been a call girl? Now, I don't mean that in a derogatory way at all. If you were an underwater welder, I would say, hey, how long have you been an underwater welder?
I don't know if you guessed it or not, but I'm not exactly an old salty dog at this.
Really?
Really.
How long have you been at this game?
Oh, let's see. Today's my first night.
No.
Yeah.
I was impressed before, but God, first day on the job, you were great.
I was great? You didn't think I was nervous or anything?
No, not at all. You passed my test of professionalism.
You were so sweet.
Well, what made you interested in tackling prostitution as a career goal?
Well, I came here from Cleveland.
Oh, okay.
There's more.
Oh.
And for about the last 3 years that I lived there, I worked at Kmart.
You worked at Kmart?
Yes, I worked at Kmart.
What department?
Records and tapes.
You lucky dog. I worked at Kmart too. I always wanted to work in records and tapes.
Really?
Yeah, out here. I always tried to get into records and tapes, but they kept sticking me in women's shoes.
No kidding. I used to feel so sorry for those guys in women's shoes. These ladies would come in and try on about 50 pairs of shoes. They'd make the guys fit them for, I don't know, could be 50 or 60 pairs of shoes until they'd finally make up their mind.
Yeah, but I have a foot fetish, so it kind of evened itself out. I remember my shining moment of glory, though, in Kmart. There was this one lady, I'm like trying to show her what size shoe she wears.
Uh-huh.
And all of a sudden this big fat rat falls out of the air duct, right in her lap.
Oh my God, I would have freaked out.
The lady, she's screaming. The rat takes off like a shot, wham, I'm going after him, okay? I'm chasing him around the store for about 15 minutes. Finally beat him to death with a broomstick and hosiery.
That is a classic. You know, I really enjoyed working in records and tapes. But I kept getting this feeling that I was having a feeling of being unfulfilled. Do you know what I mean?
I hear you talking.
So one night, I went out with this guy who worked in auto accessories. And I saw a film that was to change my life.
Which film?
Dressed to Kill.
Wonderful movie. Excellent movie. I love that movie.
You liked it?
I loved it. Brian De Palma, he's a real mean motor scooter.
Uh-huh. I loved him. I love his films. I love him. You remember Nancy Allen in it?
Remember? How can I forget her?
Okay, was she a knockout or what?
They should pass a law that says Nancy Allen has to have sex with me anytime I want.
Okay. What part did she play in that film? A call girl. That's what part she played. She was cool. She was together. Okay, I looked at that film, and I looked at her part, and I said to myself, Louise, that's the job for you.
Louise?
I mean Misty. Misty, that's the job for you. And I came out here to make my mark. And all I've been so far is an absolute failure.
What have you failed at?
Well, my pimp, Clifford. He's a lousy pimp. He's a hell of a nice guy, but he's a lousy pimp. I just had to face the fact that he was doing nothing to further my career.
so I fired him. And tonight, my first night out to bat, I blew it. A paying customer. And everything exploded. Just like that.
Well, that's hardly your fault.
How am I ever going to start a referral system? When people pay for a good time girl, they want a good time, not get involved in some miasma. Anyway, that's why I was so upset.
Are you still upset?
No.
Why?
None of your business.
You know, from the very first time I saw you dancing to that music, I said to myself, I said, self, that's my kind of woman.
Well, why didn't you do anything about it?
I didn't think you'd be interested.
What would make you think that?
I don't know. I guess I'm just stupid.
You're not stupid. You're just wrong.